Hey there, guys. I'm here with my SummerSlam Detroit 2023 predictions. It's looking like a great pay-per-view. I'm super excited. I'm going to have to rewatch the pay-per-view because I'm going to be at a live event in Charlotte the same day of SummerSlam, so I'm going to have to watch the rerun. Unfortunately, I won't be able to watch it live. But of course, once the show is done and whenever I find time after that event, I will be here with my review and ratings. First match, we got the Slim Jim Battle Royal. And you already know who's going to get himself a Slim Jim. Yeah, L.A. Knight, yeah. I'm almost 100% that L.A. Knight is going to get the win on this one. It should be good because there's a lot of very talented guys that is not on the card, and so they'll be able to be in this Battle Royal. So let's see if the crowd's man, L.A. Knight, yeah, can go get himself a Slim Jim, yeah. Next up, let's get to a match that I'm super excited for. This is Logan Paul versus my personal favorite, Ricochet. There's going to be so much talent in the ring between Logan Paul and Ricochet. And we already saw what they can do together in the Royal Rumble whenever they jumped across the ring and met for a double clothesline in the middle of the ring. That's the cool type of stuff that's going to be going on. And I'm not going to be biased, but my man Ricochet has gotten a lot better on the mic for the build-up of this match. And Logan Paul has always been great on the mic, and he's super talented in the ring. And I badly want my man Ricochet to get the win so he can prove that he's not just some random mid-carder. And honestly, I think Ricochet needs the win. Logan Paul doesn't really need it. Logan Paul can just talk it off. He can just say, oh, I had an injured shoulder or something. He's always got an excuse in the books. But looking at how WWE usually books things, I believe they're going to let Logan Paul win, unfortunately. But, of course, I'm going to be rooting for Ricochet like crazy. Next up, I've loved the build-up for this match. This is Ronda Rousey versus Shayna Baszler. The beginning of this feud is when Shayna Baszler turned on Ronda Rousey in their tag title match. And the promos that led up to this match have been great. As expected, because it's two very talented women. No matter what people say about Ronda Rousey, she's extremely talented. And I've always seen Shayna Baszler with a lot of potential. And I'm pretty sure the winner of this match is basically already confirmed. It's going to be Shayna Baszler. Because Ronda Rousey said she wants to go away from wrestling in a match with Shayna Baszler, putting Shayna Baszler over the top. And basically just giving her a push before she leaves, setting her up for success. So yeah, I think it's pretty clear that's going to be Shayna Baszler. Next up, we got a rerun of the American Nightmare Cody Rhodes versus the Beast Incarnate Brock Lesnar. We've already seen this match multiple times, so I believe this is going to be the last one. I think they're going to finish the whole feud at SummerSlam. And we already know Cody Rhodes has to finish the story, so I think it's pretty clear that Cody Rhodes is going to win this match. I don't really have too much to say because they've already went against each other multiple times. Next up, we got a match for the IC title. This is the Ring de la Ganta versus Drew McIntyre, and this should be amazing. These are two very tough men, so they ought to have a very good match together. In my opinion, I believe this is the hardest match on the card to predict because it's looking like Gunther's IC title reign is coming to an end and he's going to go to bigger gold like a world title. And in my opinion, Drew McIntyre is probably the best guy to take that title from him. It seems super real that Drew McIntyre, a man as tough as Drew McIntyre, could take down the Ring General Gunther, but it won't be easy. So my prediction is Drew McIntyre. I'm super excited for this match to see who actually wins. Next up, we got one of those like dream matches. This is a triple threat between Asuka, Bianca Belair, and Charlotte, and this is for that women's title. But I'm excited, but at the same time, I have not liked Bianca Belair's and Asuka's matches. Like, them two in the ring together just never really did it for me. They were super slow-paced. They had to have long matches just to, like, they had to span it so long to even have it be acceptable, in my opinion. But when my favorite women's wrestler of all time, Charlotte Flair, gets in there, I believe she could save the two. I believe she could make this match 5 stars or an A+, however you grade it. I grade mine with like the A-pluses in that. So yeah, I think it could be an A-plus match. I mean, if you look at the talent, it definitely looks like an A-plus match. I mean, these are three women that are easily world title potential. I mean, all three of them have been world champions. So But with things like this, I always have high expectations for these matches, so let's hope they can meet them. I'm going to have Asuka retaining, even though I'm going to be strongly rooting for my girl, Charlotte Flair. Next up, we're going to have a World Heavyweight Championship match. For me, this is another one of those matches that are super hard to predict. Because with all the Judgment Day around, it just seems like it would be so hard for Seth Rollins to take down Finn Balor. When you got Dirty Dom coming out, Rhea Ripley coming out, Damian Priest, never in a million years can I see Seth Rollins fighting through that. The Judgment Day has been so dominant recently. But Seth Rollins, if he did it once, he can do it twice. So it is really hard to predict. And this is how I think it's going to play out. Which, of course, multiple things could happen. This is just what I think is going to happen. I think Finn's going to finish off Seth. I think he's going to go for a coup de grace. And then here comes Damian. He comes in. He does his finisher on to Finn Balor, and then he cashes in the Money in the Bank, pins Seth Rollins 1-2-3. Damian Priest is your new World Heavyweight Champion. And then I think that would lead to Finn or Damian, one of the two, leaving Judgment Day. I think it would end up being Finn. But yeah, I'm excited to see what happens with that, just because there's so many options on what could happen. And this is another one of those matches that is A-plus potential just because of the talent in the ring. Next up, we got what is going to be the main event of the entire card. This is Tribal Combat. This is the Tribal Chief, or at least the current Tribal Chief, Roman Reigns versus Jey Uso. This is for the tribal thing that Roman wears around his neck, and not only that, the undisputed WWE Championship. I'm so excited for this match. I believe this is the best storyline of all time, or at least from what I've seen. Really, the only storyline that compares to this is Seth Rollins' authority. When he turned on the Shield, that was a very good storyline. But I still think it just doesn't compare to this, because it's just so personal. And who knows what Solo Sikoa might do. Solo has just... He's a good storyteller. I just want to say that. He is a very good storyteller. He makes me on the edge of my seat. He creates great suspense. I believe Jimmy Uso might end up coming out. And I would like to see there be like just a person to come out and kind of even it out for Roman. Maybe someone to come team out with Roman. And I think the perfect person for that could be Jacob Fatu. But I hope somebody from the Bloodline that's not already in the feud comes out. Like even Rikishi coming out just to cheer on his son. I would like that. There's so much you could do just because of how big the Bloodline is. But we all want to see Jey Uso win the match. But I don't think they'll give it to us. I don't know why. I just think Roman Reigns is not going to be beaten by anyone in the Bloodline. I believe the person to beat Roman Reigns is going to be Cody Rhodes. But whatever decision they make, the storyline is still going to be one of the greatest things I've ever seen in pro wrestling history. So yeah, I'm excited for SummerSlam. I hope you are. I hate I'm not going to be able to watch it live, but I will be here with you guys' review and ratings. Probably a little bit late, but I'll be here with it. I'll see you guys on the next one.